We turn now to a growing scandal in the U.S. Marine Corps, where male Marines have been caught sharing sexually explicit photos of female Marines without their consent. William Brangham has the story.
It started on a private Facebook page called Marines United. Hundreds of explicit photographs of female Marines followed by endless, obscene, degrading comments. Some of the photos appear to have been taken consensually, but others were not. None of the women identified so far said they had agreed to have their photos being posted this way. The Facebook page is gone, but many of the photos, these are some of the tamer ones, have now been uploaded to other websites. Military officials have launched an investigation, and today, Defense Secretary James Mattis, a former Marine himself, called these acts egregious violations of the fundamental values. The Commandant of the Marine Corps, General Robert Neller, also expressed his dismay.
These allegations themselves, they undermine everything that we stand for as a Marine Corps and as Marines. Discipline, honor, professionalism, and respect and trust amongst each other.
For more on this, I'm joined now by retired Colonel Mary Reinwald. She spent 27 years in the Corps and now edits Leatherneck magazine, written for the Marine Corps community. Nice to see you again. Sorry, it's under these circumstances.
Great.
Tell me, when you first heard about this, what was your reaction?
I was angry. I was absolutely angry because, you know, both General Neller and General Mattis mentioned it in their comments that, you know, this is about honor. And the Marines who did these type of things, they don't have the honor that we value as Marines. I was ashamed. I was ashamed for my Marine Corps. And I was mad for my fellow Marines. I was mad for my fellow male Marines because the vast majority of male Marines don't do this type of behavior. They're honorable, they're decent, and they're the type of human beings that everybody should aspire to. And now there's a whole segment of our country who will believe that this is what Marines do, and it's not. It's absolutely not.
And what have you been hearing from other Marines? I know you talk to them on a daily basis. What do you hear from them?
I do. I have many friends that are still on active duty. I also talked to a female Marine whose picture was posted on the website. And it was just an innocuous picture from her Instagram with her and some other female Marines. There was nothing wrong with it. They were out in public. And the photo was taken and posted on the website. And they asked, you know, in terms of her attractiveness, but they asked in much cruder terms than I would use. You know, she's an officer of Marines. She's a pilot. She's got an exemplary record. She is one of the future leaders of our Corps. And we have these individuals who decided that they were going to be disrespectful and vile and not uphold our ethos. You know, how dare they? You know, I absolutely believe that our culture has some role to play in all of this. Social
you mean
media.
American culture more broadly?
American culture more broadly. And it's very easy to get on social media and be anonymous. You know, and if these individuals, and I really do hesitate to call them Marines, if these individuals weren't the cowards that they are, they would be putting their names up there. They would be proudly proclaiming their misogyny and their disrespect toward female Marines. But this almost gang mentality on whatever social media account, whether it's Facebook or some of the others, where they feed off each other, you know, I have no respect for them because they wouldn't do it in public. They wouldn't do it in front of the Commandant, but they do it behind the anonymity of both Facebook and the web.
As you well know, the Marine Corps and all the other branches of the services are integrating women into combat roles. That's the first reason I spoke to you
right.
Several months ago. Do you think it's coincidental that the Corps is moving women into these more forward roles at the same time that this kind of a scandal breaks out?
I don't know that it's necessarily coincidental. There's probably an element of that. It's brought out more of the individuals who think back, you know, have the mentality from 50 years ago, women don't belong in the infantry, so by God, we're gonna be disrespectful to all of them. So you cannot dispute the timing in many ways. But you know, I think these guys were always there. There was always an element, a very, very small element, who had no problem saying these things, and now it's just easier to say.
And now it's just amplified.
It's amplified. And once, you know, if one makes one comment, then others feel like, hey, he said it, so I can say it too, because everybody feels this way. Well, everybody doesn't feel this way. This is not the majority of Marines.
I know you are also a great champion of women going into the Marine Corps.
Absolutely.
What do you think that this kind of a thing does to those women who are either just entering the Corps or aspire to enter the Corps?
I would not doubt for a minute that it would make them pause and ask them and have them ask themselves, hey, is this what I want to join? Is this the organization? Is this who I want to be? But I would reassure them and say, again, that this is not the majority of Marines. Ironically, I was at the United States Naval Academy last night and speaking to some future female Marines, along with Major General Lori Reynolds, the senior female on active duty in the Marine Corps. I was heartened by what I heard. I was thrilled by what not only Major General Reynolds said, but the other female Marines who are on active duty with me, who all echo in many ways what I said, our good experiences in the Marine Corps vastly outweigh our bad experiences. And we would encourage any American young lady today to join the Marine Corps.
All right, Mary Reinwald, thanks so much for being here.
Thank you.